Oh yeah. Sometimes the worst part about the cold is coming in with cold feet. So microwave slippers are an absolute must. There is absolutely nothing better than just coming in at the ice, chucking your slippers in the microwave and heating them up. You got magically warm, toasty feet. They're not very good to walk in. They're wheaty bags. They don't have any sole. They've got grippers. So you'd think they were made for walking in, but they're not. I don't know if you can hear this. Yeah, it's very soft. But it's got little toe pockets, like on the inside at the top, and they're soft, which is ideal. My second must have is a good weather app. So I have a little widget here. I'm not sure how well you can see that, but you have a hourly temperature so you can plan your day and you won't have any nasty surprises if it was gonna get down to one of the temperatures you react to. Can have a look and be like, ah, I will take some antihistamines with me. My next must have, I've spoken about this before, is my medical alert bracelet, because I have a habit of fainting in inappropriate places and you can just fall ill anywhere. So like sometimes my allergy makes me dizzy and disorientated and somebody might call an ambulance for that. So this is very helpful to have so that nobody tries to put cold things on you or just so they're aware that this could be the problem. It is not the best quality material, I will give you that, because this one has gone all orange. It's just an extra step to help keep you a bit safer. I had to get this one made, but obviously they didn't have cold urticaria and they didn't have cold allergy, so I got them to stamp it. I went with allergy because a lot of people don't know what urticaria is, which is fair, and they don't know how to say it, and I feel like this is just an easier way to be like, please don't put cold things on me. Doesn't always work. Some people don't know to check for a medical alert bracelet, but that's okay. It's there just in case somebody does. So another thing you're gonna want is you're gonna want a nice long scarf. The longer the better. You can wrap it around your face if you are caught without a mask, if you're not like me and wear one. So you can just wrap it over your face. Ta-da! And then if it's extra long, you can keep your throat and your neck, all of your face, nice and warm. Or if it's summer and you are susceptible to a cold breeze, when I'm wearing like a t-shirt, I get quite cold up here. You can just wrap it around you and wear it as a nice shawl. I say that like I've ever done that. I think I've done it like twice in my whole life. But it's an option if that is something that you would do. It'll keep you nice and warm. And the next thing is, as I've spoken about, fog mask. It looks warm, it is not warm. So I will always have one of these on. I still have to wear this outside even when it's this sunny and this bright. Woo! You do want one that fits really well. So then you can just do that and then you don't wheeze, your face is less likely to hurt. The only downside is you're quite dry lips. My next must have seems probably like a bit of an obvious one. Hot water bottle. I mean, for obvious reasons, it's gonna be warm and you can hold it, you can put your hands on it, you can put it in your bed. But what I also do is I use it to warm up my towels. So I'll have my towels folded up and I will put this in between it, like where it's folded in, so it keeps them nice and warm, because you don't have a towel rack that's like heated and our radiator isn't the best. But I just put this in and that warms them up, so when I get out of the shower I've got a nice warm towel to stop the water drying on my skin, because when that happens, it cools down and I get the lovely rash. So I like coming out of the shower and feeling clean. This helps. And this can be used to, ooh, lovely hair on it. That's not even my hair. You can use it to warm up your bed as well. So you have to get into cold sheets. It depends how sensitive your allergies are really, but you can use these for everything and they warm everything up and they're cheap. The next thing after that is smartphone friendly gloves. So these I got from Primark and they almost fit my hands. Ta-da! So can you see on the fingertips, on the thumb tips, I don't know whether that worked. But these have little metal fibres in them. I've got face recognition on my phone, so I don't have to use gloves anyway to unlock it. Doesn't work with wearing a fog mask, but where I'm from, we have an app for our bus tickets. So if I'm waiting out in the cold for the bus, I don't have to take my glove off and expose my hand to the cold to get the bus ticket up. I can just beep and ta-da! So that is a definite must. Also, gloves just keep your hands nice and warm, so you should have some gloves anyway, but they need these on it if you have a smartphone. Another thing that is a absolute must-have is you must have some sort of cold weather plan. Just an idea in your head of what you can do when the weather turns cold on you, and say your weather app has lied to you. You can have this plan in the back of your head to be like, right, if it gets cold, I'm gonna get on a bus and I'm just gonna go home. Or I'm gonna call into the nearest Boots and I'm gonna buy the antihistamines, I'm gonna take it, and I'm gonna see how I feel, and then I might go home. Or if you're out somewhere really far from home, so you've gone on holiday, what is gonna be your plan? Because some people are very sensitive to the cold and some people have really bad reactions to it, including anaphylactic shock, that can happen. So you are gonna need a plan of what you're gonna do if suddenly the weather turns.
So my next thing is this pill box. This has been an absolute lifesaver. So it's basically just a small container that I can throw in any bag, and inside it is a load of pills. And I can separate them. So these are my beta blockers, these are my painkillers, and these are my antihistamines. So I've got a, because you know, I don't always know what I'm gonna do. So sometimes I'll go to a friend's house and it'll end up being like, oh, do you want to stay the night? It's quite late, all the buses have stopped running. So you're like, yeah, okay. Oh no, I don't have my medication. Well, now I always do. Sometimes I take steroid cream with me as well, just to get rid of any other allergic rashes that I have that aren't due to the cold, but they're pretty good. And I've always got my inhaler as well. So this is an absolute must, because then you don't have to take boxes and packets, and they're all in one nice, neat little thing. And it's cute, it doesn't always look like a big bag of drugs. It's just nice and discreet, and oh my god, there's loads of fingerprints on it. Adorable. But yeah, it's just a nice, cute way of not dying.
And finally, my final must have is you must have a subscription to somebody who talks about cold urticaria. I don't know who that could possibly be. If you have enjoyed this video, drop me a like, drop me a comment asking any questions you might have, and I will address them in a Q&A. Don't forget to subscribe, I've got way more content coming every Saturday about 8 o'clock talking about cold urticaria. And I will be going into chronic pain and probably mental health at some point as well, because there's only so much allergy I can talk. See ya!